Hello, I'm Geoff. I'm a Blockman, but I operate signalling equipment. On this railway, the wonderful Talyllyn, we are adept at providing a wonderful signalling system, but using flags rather than signals. It makes it a little bit more difficult to concentrate on protection and all the other goodies that need to be applied when we're operating a railway. So we have to be really careful and thinking all the time about what needs to be done. Here at Bringlass, the morning usually starts with arrival, opening up and checking any entries that have been made into the train register book. We do this to clarify any current situations that are ongoing, problems might have been left. And there may be a reminder appliance left on a lever to indicate there was a problem. So we're checking everything when we come through the door. We're going through, we're checking the equipment, we're making sure we've got everything in place before we even start the actual job. Then we follow by taking our stop boards out, and at Bringlass we have to be extremely careful to ensure that we've got the right west board and the east end, the correct board for that. If we take the wrong one to the wrong location, then we've got to double walk back. And an old bloke like me doesn't need that kind of activity. So we look carefully first, then select the board, take it down, put it on, come back. Having put all the boards out, we're then ready to confirm to control that we are open. Having contacted control, which are the area which needs to control all aspects of the running of the railway, to ensure that we're okay and find out whether any messages for us to follow in relation to any movements that might have been authorised before we've actually opened. Whenever there is a passing place, there's going to be a token section, and that token section differs where we are on the railway. So from wharf to Pendray, that's one section of signal line, and then when we get to Pendray, we exchange the yellow token for the red token then to Bringlass, where a blue token will be issued for that portion of line between Bringlass and Quarry. From Quarry, a green token is then issued to Abergynolwyn, and when the train arrives at Abergynolwyn, another token, another yellow one this time, for Nant Gwernol. So Abergynolwyn to Nant Gwernol, and we'll have another separate token. So it's very important that we have just one token for one train on that portion of line, and that will ensure the safety of all our customers over that portion of line. Whenever a train needs to proceed between the two block posts, we need to talk to each other, and there's no easier way to do so than using the type of bell signals that we have. These are standard bell signals you'll find on many railways around the country, but for us and our regulations, we stipulate special use for certain types. So we'll have one beat on the bell. That one beat on the bell is a kind of wake-up call, and it means I've got something to say to you. Please acknowledge. So I acknowledge, and then we'll be given a type of bell signal. If it's a normal passenger train, it's going to be a 3-pause 1. And we acknowledge every message exactly as it was received to make sure it's been properly understood, because communication is absolutely vital in our role as a blockman. When a train passes the block post in rear, making its way up towards the next block post, when it passes that block post, 2 beats are sent on the bell. That means that the train is now entering the section, the portion of line between the two block posts. When it passes my block post, say at Bringlass, I will then send 2-pause 1 after I've seen that the train is complete with a tail lamp. On some of these wonderful days, it can be somewhat lonely when the storm's blowing outside and the rest. But today I've been very, very lucky. I've had the great company of Anne, who has been an excellent pupil and who is really looking forward to continuing her involvement with the Talyllyn, becoming a Blockman herself.
Hi, I'm Anne. I have been a trainee Blockman since last summer, and this is about my seventh turn now. I'm really enjoying it. It's great fun to be learning something new, and I decided that I'd like to be a Blockman because my family are all very enthusiastic about the railway and enjoy being involved and volunteering elsewhere on the railway. And so, yes, I decided that it would be my opportunity to do something on the railway as well. If you can't beat them, then join them. And I thought blocking would be a really nice thing to do. It's such a beautiful railway, and there are so many lovely scenic block posts to spend a day in a quiet, peaceful environment and to have a day just getting away from it all, really.
Of course, fundamental to ensuring safety is the recording of all movements at this location, and that is stored in the train register book. So we need to record the times that we accept a train, when we have that first ding on the bell, which is the wake-up call. Then it's the making sure that we have the right information of the type of train that's going to pass us. But every message must be recorded legibly, clearly, precisely in the train register book. On a relatively quiet day like today, we only have a few trains. This is the lilac timetable. Therefore, we only have really three trains that are out. We may have an engineer's train that might pass through. But normally, with this three train timetable, around about 12 o'clock, we expect the up train and the down train. Now, obviously, this passing place needs to safely control those movements. So usually, the up train is booked to be here before the down train, only by a matter of a minute or two. This is what we call a crossing. So the up train will have arrived having seen the yellow flag, allowing them the authority to proceed as far as the stop limit here, which is designated by the use of a white sleeper that marks off where the driver must stop. The token is then taken from the driver and is put back into the machine to confirm that the train has arrived complete. But of course, I need to let the down train come past and go through the actual loop. So I have to exchange signals again with my colleague next door and have the authority to take that token out again and issue it now to the train that's going to come through. Now that I've set the route, we are able now to give that green flag to indicate that the line is now clear all the way through. The down train can now have that token at the exchange point here outside on the level crossing. So we give them the red one and we take the blue one from them. Now that the train has gone past on the down and we are in receipt of the token between quarry and bring glass, that is returned into the machine, but again, I'll need the authority for the train to proceed, so the process continues again, and the bell signals are exchanged between myself and quarry to obtain that token out of the machine again. Once that is done, we then reset the route and we authorise the train to proceed that's been standing on the up with the green flag from the box. The token is then issued to the driver as it passes over the level crossing on its way to quarry.